Hello, Canelo. Hello, Eddie.
Hi, man.
Hey, Canelo, my question for you is this. I know you just said that, or that Eddie just said that the fight may be a little complicated in the early rounds. I wonder if you could give me your opinion about what you think is the best thing that, Caleb Plant does and the main thing that he brings to the fight that you need to take away from him to neutralize. And maybe Eddie could answer that question also.
Well, like I say, he have good boxing skills. He have a good jab, good moves. He knows what he do. But like I said before too, it's nothing new for me. I know what I need to do. I need to be patient, like Eddie say. I need to be patient and three rounds, and then start doing my jab.
When you have watched him in previous fights, if you have. I think he has a good chin. I don't think he's ever been knocked down as a professional boxer. What is your opinion about that, given the notoriety that you have with your punching power?
Oh, I hope he have a good chin, because he's going to need it.
Okay, very good. Maybe Eddie could answer that first question, Jane, about the what Plant has that they need to neutralize the most.
Eddie, contanos. ¿Qué crees que es la mayor virtud de Plant y qué crees que ustedes van a necesitar neutralizar para así poder ganar la pelea en cuanto a las virtudes de Plant se trata?
Pues la mayor virtud de Plant es la mano izquierda, tiene muy buen manejo de mano izquierda, trabaja muy bien las piernas, es un peleador que tiene muy buena defensa, entonces nosotros trabajamos para tratar de presionarlo, eso no va a ser ningún secreto, vamos a salir en el primer round a presionar la pelea.
Well, you know, Plant has three attributes that that we think are his virtues, which is, you know, his left hand, the power he has with his left hand, then his legwork and his defense. But we're gonna do what we came here to do. We're gonna fight our own style and come out and try to win the fight the way we know we can do it.
All right, thank you, Dan. The next person we have is Dan.
You might want to repeat that, Jane. Diego, you cut out.
Diego from Reforma.
Hola, Saúl. Hola, Eddie. ¿Cómo están? Oye, una pregunta para los dos. Saúl, ¿te imaginaste, te acuerdas de aquella vez que debutaste en el MGM? Hoy, después de tantos años, ¿qué recuerdas de aquella noche? ¿Qué sueños tenías que hoy tienes, que has cristalizado? Y tú, Eddie, va a ser una noche muy especial también por tu día, ¿no?
Pues sí, la verdad es que desde ahí seguía soñando, ¿no? Con lo que sigo soñando, ser uno de los mejores en la historia. Y obviamente empezamos hace 16 años, 17 años ya con esa misma mentalidad y seguimos pensando, ¿no? Todavía no nos retiramos, queremos ser los mejores en esto y seguir siéndolo, como dicen por ahí, ¿no? Lo difícil no es llegar sino mantenerse, pero creo que las dos son difíciles, ¿no? Son difíciles las dos, llegar y mantenerte, así que aquí estamos y nos faltan muchos años todavía, pero con esa misma ilusión, ¿no? De ser los mejores.
Brian, do you want me to translate?
Sure, absolutely.
Well, the question from Diego for Canelo was, you know, compared to when you made your debut here in the U.S. at the MGM Arena, you know, to where you are now, you know, what balance do you make out of everything that has happened since then? And Canelo answered that, you know, I was dreaming back then and I keep dreaming now. We are never letting our guard down, because the tough thing to do is not to get there as much as it is to keep yourself at the top. So we keep working hard and we keep trying to be better each and every single day. We go out trying to get better. And that's the bottom line. That's what I was trying to do from my first fight up until now.
Next up, we have Mark Woodger.
Canelo, I wanted to ask you about your interest in golf and how much that helps you relax when you're not training. How long have you been playing, and what is your average score when you play now?
I practice every day, and I play the weekends no matter what, if I'm in training camp or not.
How long have you been playing, and why do you enjoy it so much?
I started 2 years ago, and my handicap is around 9-10.
Oh, so you, that tournament you played in South Carolina, how much was that almost like winning a boxing match when you won your yes. when you won your division?
Almost like that.
Thank you.
Hi, Canelo. Canelo, in terms of sparring partners for this sort of fight, who have you got in terms of your training camp in preparation for this fight?
¿Con quién has hecho sesiones de sparring para esta pelea?
No escucho.
¿Con quién has hecho sesiones de sparring para esta pelea?
Con Ronald Ellis y Rashini Ellis. Son los dos hermanos.
He has sparred with Ronald and Rashini Ellis. They're both brothers, and they have been with him during this training camp.
And finally, for me, Canelo, in terms of looking ahead, is really the fight between David Benitez and Yossi Ortega, the title eliminator. If you're successful against Caleb Plant, will that be the next fight for you?
Que bueno, la pelea de Benavides contra Ortega que sucede una semana después de la tuya, ¿crees que el ganador de esa pelea será tu próximo oponente?
Bueno, veremos qué es lo que viene después. Estamos enfocados 100% en esta pelea. Veremos qué es lo que viene después. Si es la pelea que tenemos que hacer después, la haremos sin duda.
Right now, we're 100% focused on this fight. Nothing else crosses my mind. Then, if we win this fight, we will see what happens in the future. If it's the one that we are going to have on deck, we will do it no problem whatsoever.
Next is Chava.
Saludos a todos. ¿Cómo están? Hello, everyone. Saludos, Saúl. Saludos, Eddie. Felicidades, Eddie, por la nominación. Te quería preguntar, Canelo, ese fin de semana va a ser muy particular para el deporte mexicano porque no solamente estás tú tratando de escribir tu nombre con letras de oro, sino también Checo Pérez ante la posibilidad, sabemos que te gusta el automovilismo también, apuestas a un doblete por parte del deporte mexicano ese fin de semana, sería espectacular e histórico, ¿no? Tener a Checo en lo más alto del podio en la Ciudad de México y a ti con todos los cinturones allá en Las Vegas.
Así es, no, me encantaría que los dos tuviéramos un triunfo, imagínate lo que sería para México, me encantaría y pues obviamente tú sabes que soy fanático de la Fórmula 1 y me encantaría que Checo ganara en más, que más que en nuestro país, no, sería algo grandísimo.
¿Cómo lo has visto a Checo?
Muy bien, la verdad que últimamente ha estado imparable, la verdad que me gusta la manera en la que ahora sí es un más decidido, con más agresividad cuando corre, y eso es lo que lo ha hecho estar en los podios.
No sé si Martín quiere ayudar con el...
Yeah, sure, I just didn't know if you had a follow-up question to that. Okay, so there were two questions in one for Canelo. We know that Canelo is a racing fan, and it just happens that on Saturday, November 6th, he's not only going to be fighting for the Undisputed World Championship, but Checo Pérez, Sergio Pérez, is also going to be, racing in a very important Formula One fight. And he was asked about how meaningful that would be for Mexico to get, like, two wins in one day. And Canelo said that, you know, it will definitely be huge for Mexico to be able to celebrate in that fashion where both Checo and him get to have two great accomplishments. And hopefully that gets to happen so Mexico can have one big party. And then when it comes to why he likes Formula One and why he likes Checo Pérez in particular, Canelo said that he is a Formula One fan for sure and that he likes the aggressive nature that, Sergio has when he drives. And that's what's going to drive him to be a part of the podium, not only this Saturday, but in other races as well.